by focusing on our breath. First exhaling, letting out as much air as possible, maybe through the nose or the mouth. As you inhale, slowly feel the belly rise and the rib cage slightly open. Exhale, rib cage goes down, belly slightly goes down. Inhale, belly, chest. Exhale, chest, belly. Now focusing on your breath, moving with your own pace. Maybe closing your eyes to really focus in on how this feels for you right now. Just taking note. Exhale, just gently twisting over to the side. Inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale to the other side. Doing two more rounds of this, inhaling up. Exhale. Check in with the shoulder, elbow, and wrist. Make sure they're stacked, rub one over the other. And then check in with the hip over the knees. If you have very sensitive knees, you can always bring your mat and fold it to give you more cushion. Here in tabletop, we're gonna first work on engaging the core. So as you exhale, bring the belly button in as if you're trying to bring it toward your spine. Inhale, nice and strong through the core muscles, the abdomen, and also within the shoulder blades, the muscles between those two bones that kind of look like chicken wings. Exhale, belly button toward the spine. Inhale, nice and strong through your core. Exhale. Now we're going to go ahead and inhale, reach the arm here. Exhale, breathing. Now we're going to go ahead and see if at this time we want to inhale and lift opposite leg toward the back. Exhale, you are able to bring the elbow toward knee if you have both of the hand and leg extended. Inhale as you reach. Exhale. If you're just with your hand extended, feel free to just do the motion here. Inhaling. Exhaling. Being nice and strong through the core. Inhale. Exhale. Do two more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhaling. Calm down to child's pose. you're able to take your child's pose with your knees wide. If you want to get a nice stretch for the hips, or if that's not comfortable, you can always bring your knees closer together. Another modification in child's pose is to bring your arms where they are laying alongside your legs if your shoulders feel too tight. Find which child pose is best for you and take 3 calming breaths. In through the nose. Exhale. As if you're fogging up the mirror. On your last exhale, coming back up to your tabletop position, making sure you're aligned, making sure to engage the core, belly button toward the spine, and imagine that you are reaching the top of your head all the way across in front of you. So you have a nice long spine. Now we're going to do the other side. So go ahead and exhale all of the air out, belly button toward the spine. Strong in the upper back. Inhale, reaching the other arm straight ahead of you. See if you want to stay here or lift the back leg. Try our best to keep the hips nice and square and not turning. When you're ready, exhale. Elbow toward the knee, or we have the option to just do the arm. Inhale. Exhale, or come in here, doing 3. Inhale. One more. Inhaling and exhaling. Back down to your version of child's pose that you choose. 3 calming breaths. Come back up to that tabletop position. Now we're going with the cat and cow. So inhale, gently arching the back, looking up. Make sure the shoulders are not up by the ears, but bringing them down away from the ears. Exhale, arching the back, belly button toward the spine. Once again, gentle, gentle arches. Inhale up. Exhale. Let's go with 3 more. Inhale up. Exhale, arch. Move at your own pace with your breath. Use your breath as your metronome. On your last exhale, curl toes under. Push the hips up toward the sky. See if you are able to bring your heels down to the mat. Once again, make sure our shoulders are not by our ears, but feel them come back. Not up here, but pushing back and down toward our mats. You can pedal out to your downward dog here by bending opposite knee, driving the other heel down toward the mat. Nice stretch for the back of the legs as you breathe. First downward dog. Find some stillness for a moment. Take one more breath here in your downward dog. Bend your knees. Come back to your child's pose of your choice. 3 calming breaths. When you are ready, remember, you can always come back to your child's pose at any time. So don't feel rushed, and you know you can always pause the video. So I like to shake out my hands sometimes, as there are a lot of things we do with the
wrists and the hands, putting pressure there. So flipping them out, shaking them out. And when you are ready, you are going to come back to the downward dog by first coming to that tabletop, curling the toes under, then pushing hips up to sky. Now, we can find our stillness in the downward dog, checking with the shoulders. Once again, between the shoulder blades, nice and strong, as if you're trying to pinch a balloon between those two shoulder blade muscles, the scapula. And at this time, we're going to inhale, lift the leg up to sky, and then exhale. Bring the knee in toward the chest. Inhale it up to sky. Exhale, bring the knee into chest. Let's do two more. Inhale it up. Exhale. One more. Inhale up. Exhale. You can come back to your child's pose. And you probably know where we're going on your last exhale, coming back to the tabletop, other side, tuck your toes, inhale, exhale, hips up to the sky, inhale, other leg up to the sky, exhale, knee into chest, inhale. Positions, slowly rising, not too fast. That way you don't get dizzy. Let your head be the last thing to come up. So keeping the chin tucked to the chest until you are ready to bring the head up slowly. At this time, we're going to extend the legs in front of us. Now in this posture, what's most important is to keep a nice, straight, long spine. We're not trying to reach to the toes. What we're trying to do is draw the chest toward maybe the knees, the thighs, but imagine that your shoulders are down and back. Inhaling up, exhale, drive the chest now, chest toward the legs. Your legs by contracting the quads. Bring the toes back towards you to activate the muscles here in the shin. Continue to breathe. Inhale, come up. And now we're going to go ahead with the standing version. So go ahead, cross the legs, hands to the mat, undo the crossing legs, tuck the toes. Push up. Now we are in our standing version. Just kind of go ahead and let the knees bend here. We're going to get a nice stretch through the back of the hamstrings.
30 seconds.
And we're going to do one sun salutation here as we inhale. Come up nice straight line for the hips, knees, ankles, and inhale, slowly come up, hands down toward the center, and this time you can take Shavasana. Unfortunately, the video is over. If you'd like to lay down and relax and take in your breath.